guys, this is Zach from Watches On You, and today we are taking a look at a fairly recently released watch. This is the Jaeger LeCoultre Master Control Geographic with the new sector dial. And okay, right off the bat here, I'm going to let you guys know, this is the best watch ever made, all things considered. I mean, $9,400, and I'll show you why it's worth that, and many times over, when we go down to the pad right now. So, make sure you tune in. Okay guys, here's the watch in greater detail, and now I'm going to go and try to explain to you guys why this, in my opinion, is the best watch ever made, all things considered. So now I'm going to go off of its stainless steel case. So I really love how JLC utilizes stainless steel. Not a lot of, like Patek Philippe, they don't do a lot of stainless steel watches because, I mean, they try to stay with precious metals. But I like how JLC does that because it lowers the price point a lot. And like this being $9,400 from a brand that makes haute horlogerie is insane. And the case finishing, don't be fooled. It is extremely well done, even though it does not cost in excess of $20,000. You get beveled edges on the sides of the case, and actually that's a flowing bevel kind of over to the other lug where it then opens up to the whole top of the lug. And that is all polished exquisitely, if I may add. And the side of the case is brushed as well, and by the way, you see those little things. That's because there's actually a cover on the side of this watch. It's brand new. But yeah, the brushing is done really well too. See how straight the lines of light are, and that shows that they really, really put a lot of work into that, and it, believe me, it paid off. And also what you can maybe see is the side of the case back, that tiny little side, they also polished, even though you won't notice it that much. Now they also polished the bezel. Now that also looks extremely good. The light just goes right off of it. Looks very, very good. You can see in the middle that there's actually a cover there, so the bezel is actually fully polished. The reason it looks like there's brushing in the middle is because there's actually this little cover. If I can see if I can give you a little glimpse. So there's actually what it looks like, and that is done very, very, very well. Yeah, very well made. Polishing's done extremely well, especially for a watch under $10,000. Wow. So now I'm gonna go over to the dial, and I just gave you a quick peek at what's lurking behind. So the dial this watch is the new JLC's sector dial. So I really, really love it. See how they have the brushed metal on the outside and then the white matte on the inside? I mean, really, really well done. And you can see where, as this is actually a world time, sorry, you can see on the sub-dial there where it displays the second time zone, that actually has different layers to it. They cut down it. Now, I really like that too because what that shows is that they really did put effort in this watch. They didn't need to do that, but they did to give it a better look. Same, and then you can see that actually is a 24-hour indicator on the side, so you can actually see what if the time zone you're in is AM or PM, which is a very, very useful function that not a lot of watches actually end up utilizing. So now I'm going to show you guys the world time. It is indeed a genuine world time. It's not like the normal kind of disc. It actually does change the hand. So these actually stay exactly the same. That will always be your home time. But the sub-dial is what changes. So when I turn it, see how the hour hand jumps? Whenever you turn it? Yeah, very, very useful function. I actually do like how they kept it in the sub-dial just because, I don't know, I like to know. I just like the home time, very easily readable, but then you can have your second time zone at the bottom. It just looks, it's very, very well done. I love how they organized it. It's almost kind of minimalist, actually. I mean, yeah, there's a lot going on in the dial, but the design is superb. I cannot stress that enough, and you really do need to see this in person. I didn't think much of it when I saw it online. When I see this in person and how much, and I saw how much it cost, it blew my mind. So, I mean, if you can, check this thing out. Yeah, insane. So you can see it's a full world time. A lot of the world times a lot of the world times under $10,000 don't actually change hands on the dial. All they do is they have the disc that goes around and then the cities around the edge. This actually moves like a Patek Philippe, where the hand moves when you click that little pusher. But this is not a Patek Philippe price. The Patek Philippe world time in gold is going to cost you in excess of $30,000. This is costing you under $10,000. Insanely good value for money. So now, if you look at the movement, this is also really, really well done. Believe me, you're not paying for the price, you're not paying for the quality of this price by a lacking movement. The movement is done really well. Look at the finishing there. That is exquisite, especially on the rotary. That's a you get the gold rotor with beautiful Cote de Genève all over. You get perlage on the sides, perlage under the balance wheel, as you can see there, and Cote de Genève. You get everything. I mean, I'm not just saying this to try to push product. It's not like I'm not working for Wixson Jewelers who gave us this piece. Completely independent. This is an independent view. You may think I'm biased just because of how much I'm going out this. I'm not biased. This is actually insane quality for money. So be sure to check this thing out. I'm not just saying that to sell this thing. I mean, wow. Look at the movement. Under $10,000, no other company offers you that. I mean, seriously, that is almost Patek Philippe grade quality at a third of what less than a third that Patek Philippe would cost. I mean, insane. Yeah, you're not getting precious metals, but I don't think you really need to. I like the steel because it makes it. It honestly almost makes it sporty. Like, I know this is a dress, kind of a dressier watch, but it almost makes it sporty. I mean, I'd wear this on the weekend, and I would not be ashamed. Very, very well made. So, now I'll do a wrist shot. So, this watch is, again, very, very comfortable on the wrist as well. You get a nice alligator strap, and, sorry, let me get it on there. It's hard to do this with gloves. So yeah, beautiful alligator strap. Now actually though, I will say, if I were to buy this watch, I would replace the strap. I'd be honest with you there. The strap is very, very good, but I feel like if I put it on different colored leather, like a nice brown or even kind of like an almost orangish brown strap, I mean, it would look incredible. So yeah, I would change the band on it. I'll tell you that right now. But the watch itself, which is really what you're buying, impeccable quality. So yeah, overall guys, I mean, listen, I'm not being biased here. I have no way to be biased. I'm completely independent opinion. Extremely good. There's an extreme amount of quality at this piece. You're getting hot horology quality at a Rolex price. And that's kind of what JLC does. I really like what they do. They just take high complications and make them cheaper, like their perpetual calendar in stainless steel. You can find those pre-owned around $14,000, and for that is a highly regarded complication. That goes in grand complications. I mean, really, really tough to do complication, and they offer it to you at an extremely affordable price. Well, I mean, affordable relative to the other perpetual calendars. So yeah, you really need to take a look at this if you can. So remember to check out other videos, subscribe to the channel, and actually we'll leave some links in the description if you want to learn more about this piece. And remember to keep watching our videos. Thanks for watching.